Aren't we lucky having all this on our doorstep? Well, on to our final story tonight, and imagine moving to another country and not going back to where you came from for almost 60 years. Well, that's what happened to William Chong. He left Jamaica on the first sailing of the Empire Windrush and settled in Nottingham. Well, now he's been back to Jamaica as a VIP guest, and as Jeremy Ball reports, there were some big surprises waiting for him.
A trip straight out of the holiday brochures, spectacular waterfalls, swimming with dolphins. But for William Chong and his eldest son Tony, this is much more than a summer holiday. It's a trip back into William's history.
Yeah man, chicken and drink, have a nice half welcome for me.
Pull it,
yeah.
Pull it.
I've got the passport, a British passport, so I am British. Yeah. But I'm still a Jamaican because I was born in Jamaica.
The Empire Windrush brings to Britain 500 Jamaicans, citizens of the British Empire coming to the mother country with good intent.
It's 58 years since William emigrated on this, the first sailing of the Empire Windrush. It was just after the end of World War II. William was only 19 years old. He was the son of a Chinese immigrant, and his life was about to change forever.
You'd get like a bunk. It was, you know, with adventure, really. It was exciting. Because there was a lot of young lads as myself. There was musicians, there were singers.
London is the place for me.
They have high hopes like myself, you know.
This lovely city.
The first impression I had was these houses all together. Why? Why? You know, because at least where I came from, the house was like, you know, separating. That really shook me like. When I was in Jamaica, like, in going to school, there was diesel trains. Right? And when I came over here, I saw, you know, steam trains. I thought it would be more advanced. When you landed, right, the option was either the forces or the mines. Going to pits, they call it the pits, the mines. You would be a Bevin boy.
So William became a coal miner, work which brought him to live in Nottinghamshire, where they still weren't used to seeing black people.
It's really difficult because a lot of people didn't want to work with you. They said, well, in the farm, I could let you come here to work. The men wouldn't work with you because they don't like colour here. When you're working, actually working in the pit, everybody is everybody's friend. Right, actually, because if something happened to you, they have to rescue you. And if something happened to them, you have to rescue them. But after you get up from down the mines, have a shower, you might say hello, but most of them don't like it anyhow.
William moved on to a string of jobs, including here at Nottingham's world-famous rally factory, then as a builder, plumber and pie maker before he eventually retired.
Here's the photo there, the passport. 18 years, and this is the good one now. You see, what difference that is.
But William's never forgotten his Jamaican roots. This is the old colonial passport which brought him to Britain all those years ago. And now he's got a new one for his first trip back to Jamaica.
He's one third again, and that's it for now.
He'll have to go without his wife, Doreen, because she isn't well enough.
Very, very nervous. Very nervous. I don't like planes anyhow. I'm a bit scared going planes.
Well, I'm just pleased that he's able to go. And he's actually going, because he said he was going before but never went.
Will they be glad to see me? That's the next thing. You know, leaving all this time.
This is the first time William's been in a plane. The flight to Jamaica takes less than 12 hours, a far cry from the Windrush sailing, which took almost a month.
I reckon the country have changed a lot. And if I've got this chance to go now, I'll never go again, I think.
There'll be places that he will remember straight away. There'll be other places which have changed or are sadly no longer there. So it is going to be quite emotional.
Yeah.
Oh, that's okay.
You're all right.
Come on.
All right.
He never expected a welcome like this, the full VIP treatment.
Honored to present Mr. William Chong.
And an invitation to meet the Governor General, the Queen's representative in Jamaica.
Prodigal son, ain't it?
Yes.
The prodigal son, yeah.
William's trip's been paid for by one of Jamaica's biggest businesses after they found out he'd been away for so long.
We thought it was a very, very good idea for him to come back because he represents a lot of the good that was old Jamaica and a lot of the people who had tremendous ambition. They left on the Windrush to go to the UK and they've done very well. They've built the country that they have adopted as their home, but I think most Jamaicans never forget Jamaica in their hearts.
Very, very touching. All these years away and I come back and go in the governor's mansion. Astonishing, isn't it?
Today's the day William's been looking forward to most, a trip back to the neighbourhood where he grew up all those years ago. First stop, his old primary school.
How are you, sir?
Yeah,
welcome back.
Thank you very much.
That's good.
All the teachers was, you know,
yes.
They was a bit strict. You'd have the slingshot. That's the painting of Marcus Garvey. Oh, dear, dear. But I doesn't know him personal. I know his son. Very nice. So something changed, something don't. I don't think that was there. Yeah, you just sit down at the pool. They still have the same system.
Poverty is very different today than it was those days.
Yeah.
But round the corner, disappointment as William tried to find his childhood home.
Are you living here? Is your dad dad? Is your dad? Hello, how are you keeping? All right. We used to live over there, 38.
No, I don't think so.
It's all changed up.
That was the front of the house?
That was the front of the house.
You think that was the front of the house?
But you see what he put me off? It's all them walls. We never have walls.
Is it bringing back memories being here?
Not really, because it's not there. Yeah. It's not there, just not there. So, you know, you can't feel something where it's not there. Definitely. You know, it's put you off completely. Yeah, put you off completely. Yeah. Next door was the Joseph. Was you know the Joseph?
This is Joseph's home.
Yeah, he's still there.
No, man, he died.
He's died?
Long ago, yeah.
Yeah.
Believe me.
They leave?
They leave.
Oh, you see, yeah. Everything changes, yeah.
Change hands.
Are you glad you've come back today?
In one way. In the next way, it's really a waste of time.
Sad for him, but... You know, kind of the place has gone down so quickly and so badly. And, yeah, it's, you know, looking around, you can see that there are places where things must have been better in the past. And that's the sadness of it, really.
But a lot of things have changed in Jamaica. When William left, this was still a British colony. Now they're celebrating 44 years of independence, and he's a guest of honour.
Everybody I've met make me welcome, from dignitaries, you know, MPs and ministers, right back down, you know. It's very pleasing to know that I've made this trip after all these years, you know, and the people of Jamaica welcome me. I have a very, very good time. Proud to be a Jamaican. I'm always a Jamaican in my heart, you know.